Hello everyone, I'm John Franks from Chord Electronics. I'm here from England at the wonderful Hong Kong Hi-Fi Show. It's very busy and very exciting. There's a lot going off. I'd just like to send greetings from England to everyone here in Hong Kong. And I'm just very happy to be here. Regarding Alto, we decided to give it a balanced output, really for compatibility's sake. It is not a balanced amplifier. The advanced design that we have is based upon some new topologies that we've developed, notably initially from across all of our range. We call it Ultima. And we found that with Ultima, with the design topology, we could drive some new types of power FETs that are immensely powerful and give tremendous grip to the amplifier. And certainly, we don't need to balance anything. We have enough power for this size of box. The whole idea of balancing, in other words, you have two signals like that. But actually, the reality between that and that is the same. Your maximum swing is there, and whether it's between... There is a lot of nonsense spoken about balancing, and all balanced outputs give you is twice the distortions, twice the harmonic problems. It is not a solution we like to use. We don't need it, and therefore we don't use it. But in terms of compatibility, we think that it's important to be compatible with a lot of their headphones. So I think that when people hear Alto with balanced headphones going into our amplifier, they will be very happy with what they hear. All of our DACs also are not balanced. I should explain why people use balanced outputs on DAC chips, because most DAC chips have the analog and the digital circuitry all on the same chip. And this introduces noise into the substrate of the chip. So the way that they overcome the problems they have, they put a differential output on the thing to neutralize any of the noise that is being introduced into the substrate of the chip. But we don't use chip DACs. We make our own DAC with FPGA, with Robert Watt's FPGA technology. And this, we have analog and digital circuitry totally separate and across different sections of a PCB, printed circuit board. And because of that, we really don't need to balance. There is no advantage to us to go right back to the DAC and have a balanced DAC. We don't need to do it. It just doubles the distortion, so there's no point. Alto was developed for the professional market. We realized that in studios, because we supply studios and we have consumer electronics. So, but when we developed Alto for the studio market, they would be bringing outputs from their desk direct into Alto so that they could hear what was going on in the studio. When we built Alto, we realized that actually there's a lot of interest from people in the consumer market. A lot of people are messing around with, you know, studios at home and this sort of thing. And we decided that, yeah, really, we should bring this product over and allow consumers the opportunity to buy Alto because it's got a fantastic amplifier section in it. And it really is a very, very good headphone driver. I felt in a way we were missing out on sales and they were missing out on having the opportunity to have a really good amplifier, you know, just the average consumer. So we're calling it Prosumer. So it's the first number one of our Prosumer products. It fits in our professional range, but we're allowing consumers to buy it. It's been asked, why is Alto different looking to many of our other consumer products? Really, Alto is a professional product designed to go into studio systems, and we have many of them already in studios, where people are mixing records and you know the sound producers are working with us, and they have been working with our amplifiers for a long time, and they know our sound, but they're very happy that they can now have their own headphone amplifier. You know, that is a true Chord product. So what we decided was that consumers seem to be very interested in Alto. We'd taken it to various Can Jam shows around the world, and there is a high level of interest. So we decided, okay, this is the first product that we'll bring across from our Pro range and allow consumers to buy it. All of our distributors were saying, please, can we have this product to sell? So it's something, it's hard for us to ignore that. So we decided, for those reasons, that we will have our first prosumer product. Consumer, professional, prosumer. So that's what we've done this time. We have a large portfolio of products that we've been developing. Really, since COVID, I spent a lot of time in my lab, not being able to travel. So I did a lot of design work. And now we're seeing the benefits of that effort coming through into production. So it's quite an exciting time for us as a Chord. And we're really happy to really put the word out and show what we've been doing. For regarding Mojo and Hugo, there will be future products at some stage, but we're not actively designing at the moment of a new product. There are no plans because Mojo 2 is relatively new. Now, in terms of connection, there are several adapters that you can buy very simply. You can plug straight into our unit. As I say, we're not going to go back and balance our DACs. We don't need to do that. So really, because we don't need to do it, it's almost better to buy an adapter if you have a compatibility product. We'll also be looking at some adapters ourselves. And I think I will probably try to do a deal with a manufacturer so I can give them away with every Mojo. If we will look very carefully at the makeup of the adapters, of the quality of the connections, of the inside, the PCB, if it's good enough, we will say it's okay. If they wired the earths in the right way, it'll be okay. So it's down to us to look, take them apart, and decide. We can give these away, or we can let them people have them at a discount, whatever. You know, that's the main thing for us. Okay, you're talking about dongle DAC. It is possible, but the only problem is that dongle DACs are normally using ESS or similar DAC chip. And these are relatively cheap. Rob Watt's technology, when we buy it from Rob, is not cheap. And also, the chips are much larger and much more expensive. So we could not compete with price with the cheap dongle DAC. So therefore, we would only have an expensive dongle DAC that may interfere with the sales of Mojo 2. So there are possibilities, but it's difficult for us to see a big market in dongle DACs. We've seen, we have not seen huge growth in dongle DACs. They're selling, but they're not doing that well. So because of that, in two minds about bringing forward a product, we have a product available, but we haven't brought it to the market yet. So we'll decide. When I do, you'll be the first to know, or if and when I do. Yes. Yeah, I agree. I do agree. And fortunately, I've developed another system which is physically quite small. Would you like to see it? This is our product called Suzi. Yeah, it's coming to the market very soon. Yeah. Yeah. So this is very compact. This unit is, this is a Hugo 2 and a 2Go streamer. So this is a complete streaming amplifier, but it's a very high quality amplifier with a lot of drive capability. You can drive any loudspeakers with this amp. So very capable, very compact and modular. So if you're not into digital streaming and you're interested having a fully integrated amplifier, we have RIAA input stage, so you can go straight into this with a turntable. Once again, it's a completely modular system. It just plugs into Suzi, and it makes it a complete streaming amplifier. Yes, there is interest, and we are looking at various designs. The price for streamers is going down and down and down. I mean, it's in the early days, people like Naim and Lin were putting streamers out for 10, 12, 15,000 pounds. But now, you know, there are Chinese products that are coming through very low price, and they're quite capable, not perfect. They don't have super DACs inside. But there again, you only need a streamer input to one of our DACs. So really, we can use any streamer. And we have to look very, very carefully at the streaming market, purely because it's something that maybe we could easily catch a cold on, because the software can tend to be complex. It took us a long time to get our Poly streamer working really well. It is working brilliantly now, but it's much later on in the product life cycle. So I think the main thing is that we are looking at the market, but we are developing some things, but I can't really talk about them at this stage. But always we will have great DAC technology, i.e. Robert Watt's technology within our products. This is our new phono stage, which is in development. It'll be a very high-end product. It has three inputs, and each of them can be configured for gain or impedance, either MM or MC. There are rumble filters and various other filter options in the product, and we think it's a nice looking, unusual product. I've gone back to BU meters for a bit of style. So this product should be with us by the end of the year. We may see something, maybe springtime perhaps. So this is the unit, how it looks in black, just there. So this is our Dave DAC. One of the best DACs in the world. But now Rob Watts has been working on a scaler for Dave, very high performance scaler, 4 million taps, digital taps inside, very high power. It has to have its own separate power supply, because it takes so much power, and it will be the perfect accompaniment. These three items now make this product the best DAC in the world. By far, it has no competitors at any price. So if someone comes along with a DAC and they say, oh, this is our $50,000 DAC, this one will beat it, hands down, not a problem. These are other pro products that we're developing. And this is an amplifier, but I've decided to make it just essentially 20 millimeters tall. So very, very slim, so you can have stack them to have multiple, so you can have active speakers. So there you go. That's what I've been working on. I've been quite busy. Okay, thank you.